Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the dSPACE coffee break videos. I would like to show you today our solution for bus simulation at dSPACE. So this topic seems to be not important to most of you, but that's not right. So bus simulation is an increasing part of all applications in our vehicles. That's mainly because of the increasing bandwidth, which are needed, for example, for ADAS application. And I will show you today how we can deal with this increasing and important part in our systems. So I would like to show you that with our new tooling, which is called the Bus Manager. So let's start with a short introduction. The Bus Manager is our new universal bus simulation tool, which is overarching over all application areas. So it can be used for RCP applications, for HIL, and for software-in-the-loop applications. It supports CAN, CAN-FD, LIN, and will also support Ethernet some IP later. The Bus Manager itself is completely model environment independent. That means you have the possibility to do a simulation together with MATLAB Simulink, with Daimler, with FMUs, and with all the different tools which you need in your application areas. As mentioned before, we consistently support that, and that's also one of our big benefits. So bus simulations you have done can be reused independently for which platform you have done that. A bus simulation which you have done for the micro auto box for an in-vehicle use case can be used in software-in-the-loop use cases or partly also for HIL applications and can be just added or enhanced for that, that application. The behavior itself of the simulation is completely independent. And here we also follow completely the AUTOSAR approach that signals are, for example, bus or communication system independent. AUTOSAR is a very good topic because, of course, we support the latest AUTOSAR features, for example, like secure onboard communication, global time synchronization, or the end-to-end protection profiles. Of course, the Bus Manager has a tool automation interface. That means every simulation feature you have can be automated, for example, via Python. So let's go a little bit deeper into the Bus Manager and why you should use the Bus Manager. So there are a lot of bus simulation tools on the market, but our benefit for you is that we support all the features which you need for your simulation, for your testing, for your development task directly in our tooling. So there is no need for hand programming in your applications. We all know that AUTOSAR is a very complex topic and the bus communication features are getting bigger and bigger. So we support all these features directly. So for example, end-to-end protection profiles are directly imported within the AUTOSAR communication matrix and are directly used in the simulation without a need of a specific configuration. And all that done is done consistently through all the different application areas. So let's have a look how the Bus Manager is integrated into our toolchain. So the Bus Manager, as I mentioned before, is a central tooling for configuring the buses, but there is also additional parts needed. For example, configuring the hardware. That is done with Configuration Desk, like for the other platforms. The models itself, or the model connection, is also done via Configuration Desk with the Open Standards FMI, or for example, with SIX for MATLAB Simulink. Then we have Control Desk with the Bus Navigator as a tooling for experimenting and testing. Let's have a look on the features of the bus manager. So the bus manager has the possibility to import, of course, communication metrics. You can also add signals to the communication metrics. You have the possibility to visualize the communication metrics, to customize your views, your simulation views, as well as your view of the communication metrics. The configuration itself is done via drag and drop, so quite easy without any scripting. The configuration can be done across several communication metrics, so you are open how modular your bus configuration should be. The model interface is done via model pod blocks, so tool independent, and the bus manager generates, after creating code, some information for our test and experiment tooling so that you can directly access the simulation from the tools later. The tool automation interface is done via a generic interface which can be addressed via Python. Let's have a look on the tool chain. Typically, you start with a communication matrix, which is imported by our bus manager. And the bus manager is available in two versions, one version within Configuration Desk and one version as standalone for software-in-the-loop applications. With the bus manager, a configuration is generated, which then can be imported, for example, as a BSC in our simulation platforms. Afterwards, with Control Desk Bus Navigator, you can access that simulations, and there's no difference between the experiment layouts in VIOS or for Scalexio or Micro Autobox. So you have a full reusable configuration from the starting point to the end. At the last point, I would emphasize to the Control Desk Bus Navigator. So the Bus Navigator, as mentioned before, is a tooling where you can access the bus simulation. So everything you have done in the bus manager can be handled via the Bus Navigator. So you have an access to all the signals, to all the PDUs, all the simulation and manipulation features which you have configured in the bus manager can be directly accessed via pre-configured layouts in Control Desk Bus Navigator. Additionally, you have the possibility to monitor or log the bus communication with the same communication controllers. So there's no need for special or additional hardware or additional tooling. And in that case, if you use the Control Desk Bus Navigator, it's completely synchronized as well. So now I would like to show you that on a short tool demonstration. I've now opened here an empty Configuration Desk project. So as I mentioned before, for the real-time simulation with Scalexio and Micro Autobox, the bus manager is integrated into Configuration Desk, our existing implementation tooling. For VIOS, of course, we have a bus manager standalone. So in this bus manager project, I have to switch here to the buses, and that's it. So now I'm in the bus manager. On the left side, I have the view for the different communication metrics, which can be imported. In the middle column, you have the possibility to configure the simulation itself with a few tabs for the different topics. And on the right side, you have a property where you can access and view all the entities of the simulation and of your elements. So let's start with a simple configuration of a REST bus simulation. So first of all, I have to import a communication matrix. I can do that here via right click. I can add a communication matrix. So Now I'm adding an RXML, so an AUTOSAR communication matrix. This one consists of four clusters, two CAN clusters, two LIN clusters. And if I now want to do the simulation, I only have to use that ECU, and via drag and drop, I put it into my configuration window. And now I'm ready, so I'm already configured a static RESPA simulation for that central gateway ECU with all the values which are specified into the communication matrix. So quite easy. Now I can add and extend the simulation, for example, that I can have access from the real-time model or from the test automation access. What I can also do, I can have different communication matrices which are in one communication. So therefore, I add an additional communication matrix. So here I have, for example, a different version of that communication matrix, and I can add a second ECU to the same configuration. Quite simple. I also have the possibility, of course, to change my view here to a more, let's say, AUTOSAR style view, where I only see the different ECUs with the PDUs and signals below. I also see which signals are already in use and which are, for example, not in use. To extend our simulation, to do a dynamic simulation out of the real-time model, I have to add interfaces to MATLAB Simulink, for example. That's quite simple. I have to go to this tab, and here I have the possibility to enable a model access. I will do that. So now I've enabled the model access for all my signals, and I can do the same also for the test automation access that I have access from control desk. But let's go one step deeper into a more complex configuration. So as I mentioned before, one of our benefits of our tooling is that we provide you all needed features directly in our tooling. So let's open a more complex communication matrix. I have here an AUTOSAR 4.3 communication matrix, and you directly see that this communication matrix is a lot bigger. And you also directly see that, for example, it is recognized that there are several secured PDUs and also multiplex PDUs and some PDUs and information with an end-to-end protection. So I can easily add this ECU, to the simulation. And now I have access, for example, to the different secured PDUs. Here you see directly in the property grid the information about the SecOC authentication, about the freshness value. And for example, if I look into that one here, you have directly access to the end-to-end protection profiles. And also here it is shown that even in this case, the end-to-end protection, in this case, an end-to-end protection profile 5 is directly enabled. So there is no need for additional hand programming, for additional scripting in our tools. So that's one of our benefits, or one of our basic benefits of our tooling. I would be glad if you come back to dSPACE. If you have questions, just call us, contact us. We are open for you. Thanks a lot.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.